After 5 years of deliberations, the federal government has awarded a lucrative defence contract to South Korea. Billions of dollars will be spent building state-of-the-art infantry fighting vehicles in Australia, replacing our Vietnam-era fleet.
Approaching the tomb of the unknown warrior, two prime ministers pay respect to the Anzacs at the Wellington War Memorial.
Together, we're stronger than as just single nations.
Honouring our military history. As the Australian Defence Force prepares for a new era.
We're replacing a 1960s technology with a 21st century technology.
Turning to another friend for firepower exactly 70 years since fighting ended in the Korean War, the federal government today confirming it'll spend $5 to $7 billion on 129 Redback infantry fighting vehicles by South Korean manufacturer Hanwha.
Providing the protection, mobility and firepower needed by soldiers in close combat.
They'll be built over the next 5 years in Geelong, the Defence Minister's electorate. He says he sat out of the decision.
This is going to be hugely transformative for the Geelong region and for Australian defence industry.
Hanwha beating German rival Rheinmetall for the contract, triggering fears this could jeopardise Berlin's purchase of 100 Brisbane-built combat vehicles or EU free trade deal negotiations.
We are concerned that this decision will damage the relationship.
So they are separate matters, and we'll continue to engage with the government of Germany on that.
This is the first major defence deal Canberra's ever struck with a non-Western country, signalling to the region Australia wants to have security with Asia, not just from it.
To really shore up our collective capabilities to uphold a favourable balance of power vis-a-vis China right now.
In its geopolitical power struggle with the US, the Prime Minister's now in Brisbane for AUSMIN.
Discussing AUKUS and our cooperation in defence.
High-level security meetings with the American Secretaries of State and Defence.
We've got a really busy few days ahead. It's the most important meeting that we do between our two countries.
Chloe Bourris for 10 News First.